Hi guys, Jack here from Park Place, and it's time for Ask the Engineer. Joining me today is Field Service Engineer Yogen Balakrishnan. Yogen, how's it going?
I'm doing great.
It's great to hear. Yogen, today's question is regarding cache battery failures. It seems this is a common problem, but what is a cache battery failure and what are the ramifications?
Okay, so this is a very interesting question. So the function of a RAID controller cache is to help increase I/O write performance on a server. It temporarily caches data from the host system until it gets successfully written to the disk. So without the cache, the controller has to stop the flow of data until the disk acknowledges that it's ready to receive new data, and this slows down the data transfer process. Now, the function of the cache battery here is to actually hold or protect the data in the cache in case of any power failures. This battery is capable of holding power for up to about 72 hours. So without a backup battery, the data in the cache will be permanently lost, and this can lead to data corruption. Hence why it's a protection feature. When the battery failure has been detected by the controller, it actually disables the cache. So this avoids data loss from happening. And when it gets disabled, we start noticing that the I/O operations on the server starts to slow down. And, since the cache has been disabled. And there was a study done on a lab environment where we could see an impact on the performance metrics by up to 70% with the write cache disabled.
Yogen, how would you avoid a cache battery failure?
So in the field, we often see these cache battery failures, especially on the older generation servers. The management software actually fails to highlight this failure, so we actually miss it out. On average, the cache batteries last up to 3 years. So for older servers, I would recommend, it'd be good if you periodically log into the servers to do a health check, just to make sure that the battery is healthy, the cache is enabled, but alternatively, we can actually configure email alerting via SMTP, or better still is to use a monitoring solution to pick these faults up. So there are many monitoring tools available in the market right now. They are capable of, proactively detecting these faults before they occur or as they occur. So this gives us time to actually plan, the downtime and have the battery replaced to avoid any outage. So, that's about it from my side.
Yeah, I mean, great. Thank you, Yogen, for parting with your knowledge on your topic there. Some real interesting areas covered. I'm sure it'll be useful for many out there. If you'd like to suggest a question to one of our engineers, please feel free to reach out to us. For now, we'll see you next time on Ask the Engineer.